Good morning students, welcome to class 11. My name is Salvin. I am your physics teacher. What is your common opinion about physics? Is it easy or is it really tough? Some are having the opinion that it is easy, others are telling it is tough. Some others are telling it is difficult to understand or comprehend. But think in a usual way. When you look at our surroundings, you have seen many things are happening around us. In your room itself, you can see bulbs, fan, AC, TV, many things. And if you are going outside, you need to use a vehicle. And to write, you need a pen. And everything, each and everything in our life is related to physics. So physics is actually the basics of the all science. We can say like that. So according to my opinion, it is not as difficult as you think. If you try to understand and if you create an interest in a certain subject, then it is easy. And once you create the interest, you can easily reproduce the content. For example, you are going to watch a movie, Avengers. I hope all of you have seen Avengers. So, it contains lot of physics. They are talking about only physics. But still, the movie is very interesting that once or twice you watch the movie, you will be able to reproduce the entire content. If I ask any question regarding Avengers Endgame, obviously you will be answering. Because you are not bothered about the exam, you are not bothered about what the real thing behind it. Because you don't have to write the exam, there are no marks, nothing. It is just a matter of your interest. And as a result, you are just creating the things. You are just reproducing the things. That's all I want to say. In our subject, what I would like to implement is create the interest in the subject. Understand the basic concepts and just move on through the concepts. And you can write the answers by your own words. You don't have to ratify the things. You don't have to by heart certain sentences as you have done in 9th standard or 10th standard. We don't want that. I only want you to understand the concepts, reproduce the concepts in your own way. Okay. Now, speaking about 11th standard physics, it is actually the continuation of what you have done in class 9. So, it deals with motion in a straight line, it deals with work energy and power, it deals with sound, gravitation, pressure, force and so on. So, these are the things, these are the main things that we are going to have in class 11. So nothing is difficult, it's just quite easy. So let us begin. We are beginning with chapter 2, units and measurements. This chapter comprises of the fundamental units, the conversions and the basic stuffs what we need in class 11 and class 12. So let us move on to the chapter. Physics is an exact science which expresses various natural phenomena in terms of the relationship among the quantities involved. For example, the vehicle is moving. So I have to think about the speed of the vehicle. And how will I calculate the speed? I have to measure the distance, I have to measure the time, and then divide speed and time. Speed divided by time is distance. So we are expressing a quantity speed in terms of distance and time. That is what I meant. We discuss a phenomena in terms of the relationship among the physical quantities involved. So what is meant by a physical quantity? Physical quantity means it is a quantity which can be measured directly or indirectly. The quantities which can be measured directly or indirectly is called a physical quantity. Physical quantity is classified into two. The first one is fundamental quantity, and second one is derived quantity. So what is meant by fundamental quantity? Fundamental quantity means it is the basic physical quantity which we can directly measure. It is a basic physical quantity which we can directly measure. And in terms of this physical quantity, every other quantities can be obtained. For example, in my first example itself, I told speed. Speed is not a fundamental quantity. Speed is a derived quantity. Speed, how will we calculate the speed? First, we measure the distance, then we measure the time. So distance and time are fundamental quantities. Distance means length. So we will calculate, we will measure the length, we will measure the time. Both of them are fundamental quantities, and then we will calculate speed based on distance and time. Distance by time is equal to speed. Speed is a derived quantity. Okay. So mass, length, time, current, etc., all those things comes under fundamental quantities. And velocity, acceleration, force, pressure, those quantities comes under derived quantities. So all the derived quantities can be expressed in terms of fundamental quantities. Now, what is a physical unit? We need a unit for everything, right? For example, what is the unit of time? Some will say second, some will say minute, some will say hours, days, years. So all those things are different units of time. Similarly, unit of length can be centimeter, meter, kilometer, etc. So we need a unit to express a physical quantity. When I say about a unit, it should be of the same kind. For example, if I am measuring a length, it should be of the same pattern. If I ask you, what is the length of the book? Will you say, sir, the length of the book is 10 seconds? Is it right? No, obviously not. You will say length in centimeter, or you will say it in millimeter. That is convenient. Will anybody say the length of the book in kilometers? No. You can either say in millimeter or in centimeter. So it should be of convenient size, and it should be regarding the same quantity. Then only you will be able to measure. Okay, so let us now see what are the characteristics of a unit. The first characteristics is it is well defined. There should be a proper definition for some particular unit. For example, length. When I say length and when I say 1 meter, it should be same not only in India, it should also be same in America, it should be same in anywhere in the world. So it should be well defined. Before the unit was discovered, they were using the arm length as the measurement, and there may be, they may be using foot length like that. But you already know that the length of the arm. See, the length of my arm is big. For some persons, the length of the arm will be short. So there shouldn't be a difference in a particular unit. Okay. So that is why I told it should be well defined. It should be always of the same pattern. Second one, it should be of convenient size. That is why I told you, when I ask the length of the book, you will not say it in kilometer. You will say either in centimeter or millimeters. That is why I told it should be convenient size. Third one, it should be easily reproducible. That means, see, for example, when I say 1 centimeter, it is 10 millimeter. When I say 1 meter, it is 100 centimeter. Like that, it should be easily reproducible. Then, the fourth point, it should not be affected by the physical conditions like temperature, pressure, etc. The unit should not vary. Then the last thing, it is internationally acceptable. So if you go anywhere in the world, it should be acceptable everywhere in an equal manner. And I can say like this, what is my mass? I say 70 kg. If I go and say 70 kg everywhere in the world, they will understand. They will understand what is actually 70 kg. But if I say it in pound, there is another unit which is used in British system, pound. When I say my mass in pound, or when I say my weight in pound, will you understand? No, because you have no idea how much 1 pound is. You will not understand. When I say my weight in quintal, will you understand? No. So those things are locally used in certain countries, but it is not used worldwide. A proper unit means it should be same everywhere in the world. Okay. Now, there are different system of units which is used in different countries. The first one is CGS system. As the name represents, CGS means centimeter, gram, second. That means for length they use centimeter, and for measuring the mass they use gram, and for measuring the time they use seconds. Second one is FPS system. F for foot, P for pound, and S for second. So foot, pound, second. Measuring the length is by foot, measuring the mass is by pound, and measuring the time is by second. Now third one is MKS. MKS, M for meter, K for kilogram, and S for second. So here, measurement of mass is using meter, measurement of length is by using meter, measurement of mass is by using kilogram, and measurement of time is by seconds. These all are the different systems used in different countries. In India, we are using CGS. In Britain, they are using FPS. In America, they use MKS. Now, apart from all these three things, there is the main important thing, which is SI, International System of Units. This is worldly acceptable. So everywhere in the textbook, everywhere in the world, they only use SI unit. So if I speak about SI unit, if I speak in SI unit, everyone can understand. That's the advantage. So according to SI system, there are seven fundamental units, and the rest of them are derived. So in physics we have only 7 fundamental units and 2 supplementary units, and apart from that all the other units are derived units. So let us see the fundamental units and their fundamental quantities and their units. So basic SI units, first one is length, and for the length the unit is meter. Second is mass, it is kilogram. Third one is time, and the unit is second. Fourth one is electric current, and the unit is ampere. Fifth one is temperature, the unit is Kelvin. The last one is amount of substance, the unit is mole. Last one is luminous intensity. Luminous intensity, it and the unit is candela. We write CD, candela. So these are the 7 fundamental units. Luminous intensity means actually the brightness of a light, of any light. Now apart from 7 fundamental units, there are 2 supplementary units also. The first one is plane angle, and plane angle means the angle usually we measure using protractor, and we measure it in degree, that is used in Indian system. The SI system, in the SI system the angle, the unit of angle is radian. So plane angle unit is radian. And the next one, solid angle. You haven't studied solid angle. Solid angle is in three-dimensional geometry, 3D geometry. So for solid angle, SI unit is steradian, and we write it as SR. Now let us see what is the advantages of SI over every other system of units. We told SI unit is internationally acceptable and we are using it everywhere. Why? The first thing, it is coherent. Coherent meaning it can cover all the branches of physics. All the branches of physics. This, using this SI system, we can define any unit or any physical quantity. That is why it is called coherent. It will cover all the branches of the physics. Now second one, it is a rational system. So rational numbering, you can use it. Then third one, it is a metric system. Metric system you already know. See, when I say 1 meter, it is 100 centimeter. When I say 1 kilometer, it is 1000 meter. Like that we can multiply or divide a fixed number to change one unit to another, one system of unit to another. So that is why it is called metric system. Normal mathematics, addition, subtraction, multiplication, division can be applied in this unit. That is why it is called metric system. Now third one, a fourth one, it is easily reproducible. We have discussed this already. It is easily reproducible. And fourth one, it is internationally acceptable. So because of these reasons, we accept SI units worldwide. I hope you have understood this topic, and we will deal with the next topic in the next section. Thank you.